As I whispered down the line at 11:39, when the night mail's ready to depart, saying, "Skimble, where is Skimble? Has he gone to hunt the thimble? We must find him or the train can't start." All the guards and all the porters and the station master's daughters would be searching high and low, saying, "Skimble, where is Skimble? For unless he's very nimble, then the night mail just can't go." It's 11:42 with the signal overdue, and the passengers all frantic to a man.
That's when I would appear, and I'd saunter to the rear. I'd been busy in the luggage van.
Then he gives one flash of his brass green eyes, and the signal goes all clear.
And we're off at last for the northern part of the northern hemisphere. Supervise them all, more or less. I will watch you without winking, and I'll see what you are thinking, and it's certain that I wouldn't approve of hilarity and riot. So the folk are very quiet when Skimble is about and on the move.
You can play no pranks with Skimbleshanks.
I'm a cat that cannot be ignored,
so nothing goes wrong on the northern.
Pleasant when you found your little den with your name written up on the door. And the berth is very neat with the newly folded sheet, and there's not a speck of dust on the floor. Then the guard looks in politely and will ask you very brightly, "Do you like your morning tea?"
Weak or strong?
But I was just behind him and was ready to remind him,
for Skimble won't let anything go wrong. When you creep into
it's very nice to know that you won't be bothered by mice. You can leave all that to the railway cat, the cat of the railway train.